Hi, I'm Jenny Kobiela-Mondor. I'm the Assistant Director at Eckhart Public Library, and I am the facilitator of the Brews+Books Book Club. This month, I read Gideon the Ninth by Tamsyn Muir. This is actually the second time that I've read this book. The first time I read it was shortly after it came out because I looked at it and I went, that is a really cool cover. I am going to read this book. Sometimes we do judge a book by its cover. And I'm glad that I read it, and I'm glad that I read it a second time. So it's a book that's about Gideon, this main character. She is a swordswoman, and she travels with her necromancer enemy, Harrow, to a crumbling gothic house on another planet for a chance for Harrow to become an immortal servant of the resurrection. So right now, you're probably either going, that sounds like the coolest book ever, or I do not want to read this book. I really enjoyed this book, but it is very complex, and that's why I really was glad I read it a second time. There's seven other houses that have a necromancer and a necromancer servant called a cavalier, all competing. They're all in this house. There's some weird dealings going on, as happens with necromancers. And so it's kind of this locked room mystery going on. They communicate with the dead. They use some magic and everything. So it gets kind of like heady and complex, and you're trying to remember the different kinds of necromancy that everybody does. It actually has a, in the beginning, before the book starts, it actually has a list of the different houses and their characters and what they do, which was really helpful. I flipped back to it quite a few times. I think it's worth the investment into time and like thinking, because it's an interesting read. It's creepy, of course, but it's also funny. It's kind of a dark, funny book. And it's got great characters. Obviously, Gideon and Harrow are really interesting. They're kind of your unlikable characters in some ways, but they're just so fascinating, and they do such interesting things. And then there's all these side characters who are, each have their own personalities and their own type of magic and their own upbringing. And it takes all these tropes and puts it into this play, into this like strange place, this like space castle thing. So it's kind of got your gothic, crumbling gothic house. So if you like a gothic mystery or a gothic book, you might like it. If you like the kind of horror part of the magic and the necromancy, it has things kind of like an enemies to lovers plot going on. It's just so fun and different. It has a really unique voice. So I really enjoyed it. And I grew to really like the characters. It's the first book in a planned trilogy. The second book came out, I think, last year. And part of the reason I wanted to read this again was so that I could read the second book, because I couldn't quite remember everything that had happened. But if you really, if you read this book, I'm really interested in what you think. I think it's gonna be one of the most fun kind of books, the kind that has a lot of interest and people have a lot of differing opinions about. I think some people will think this is the coolest book they've ever read. I think some people are going to go, ooh, I'm not so sure about this. So if you do wanna try it out, you can put it on hold through Evergreen or speak to a staff member and we can get it on hold for you. Or it is available via Overdrive. I'm gonna have a full list of book club questions and read-alikes on our website. And I'm really interested to see your comments. You can post them below this video and let me know what you thought. I just also wanna thank Auburn Brewing Company. They are our partners for Brews+Books, and we haven't been able to meet there for several months, but we're really looking forward to getting back to that, and we are so thankful for them as a partner.